Can I get an amen from somebody over here? Amen. Folks will lie. Can I get an amen from somebody over here? Here's the big one. The devil is a liar. Amen. Yeah. All the devil do is lie. The devil a liar if you look at it. He's a liar. And it's important for you guys to recognize when the devil is lying to you. All right, so in a perfect world, I could make it. Your mamas could make it. Your dads could make it. Your pastors could make it to where the devil never spoke to you. Because if I can make that happen, I'd do it. If I could do something for me, where the devil never talked to you, I would do it. If I could push a button and make that happen, I would do it. But I can't. So the next best thing I can do is make sure that if the devil talked to you, you can at least recognize when it's the devil that's talking to you. All right? So there's this expression y'all be using. And let me tell y'all this. I'm a teacher and I'm a coach. I teach at Bryan High School. I used to coach basketball and track. I have taught some of you in this room. I dare not embarrass you and tell everybody that I'm your teacher, Jaylen Bowden. And I remember you. She was looking at me going, please don't tell them me. I remember you too. So some of you, I've been your teacher before. And then some of you are youth at Fresh Start Ministries. If you go to church with me at Fresh Start Ministries, you're a part of Tiny Treasures, or you're a part of Fresh Start Ministries, just put your hands up in the air. Represent, put your hands up high. Fresh Start in the building. If you're from my home church in Navasota, Mount Calvary Baptist Church, put your hands up in the air. Let them know that Navasota is in the building. Okay, so with that being said, I want to teach you how to apply y'all strategy of that's cap, because I had noticed y'all say that a lot, right? And so the first couple times I heard that in my classroom, I was embarrassed to admit I ain't know what it meant, right? So I would hear my students all the time, somebody would yell out an answer, and I hear somebody say, that's cap. Well, let me ask y'all real quick. Do y'all know what that's cap mean? When people say, that's cap, you know what it mean? What it mean? Say it out loud. It mean that's a lie. And what I notice is a lot of times you guys tell your friends, some of you even tell your teachers, that's cap. Okay, that's fine and dandy, but I'm here to challenge you today to learn how to tell the devil that's cap. In other words, I'm here to challenge you that, you know, tell the truth. How many of y'all, like, you've been guilty sometimes of talking back? Tell the truth. Tell the truth. Tell the truth. Amen. I appreciate everybody here. 100% of the room is walking in truth tonight. I think that's beautiful. I think that's beautiful. Hey, I'm going to tell y'all something. Talking back ain't always a bad thing. You just got to know who to talk back to. I wish I had some grown folks that could be witnessing in the room. You got to know who to talk back to. And what I had started noticing about us is that a lot of times we be big and bad and grown in all the wrong spaces.
Yeah.
We be talking back to all the wrong people.
Yeah.
I'm getting ready to give you permission tonight to talk back and be big and be bad and be adult-like and be mature to the devil.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is some of that energy we be using sometimes with each other in the yard and on our snaps.
Yeah, on
Snapchat. On our Snapchats, on our Instagram, we in DMC. When we in DMC, DAEP, ISS, OCS, sometimes that energy we have in there, we need to keep that same energy. We just got to learn how to use it at the right time. So what I'm telling you tonight, ain't nothing wrong with being. How many of y'all like this? I ain't scared. Tell the truth. I ain't scared. Who's that? Who feels like that? I wish somebody would run up on me. I ain't scared. Who's that? Right on. And that's great. But you got to learn to have that mentality when it comes to the devil. Because let me tell you, the devil don't just be bothering grown people. The devil is after you and after you and after you and after you. And I'm here to teach you tonight how to recognize the voice of the enemy, the voice of the devil, the voice of Satan. All right? When you hear the devil speak to you again, you have to have the audacity to say, that's cap. Okay? Here's what the devil likes to say. The devil, I'm going to give you some examples, likes to discourage you. I'm going to describe a scenario. Have y'all ever been about to do something? You was excited about it. Maybe you was going to try for a team. Or maybe you were about to take a test at school. And all of a sudden, you just kind of felt sad. Now talk back. Like y'all doing class. Talk back. Come on. Yeah, have you ever been up? And it's like, man, it's like, oh, or you feel afraid.
Yeah.
You say, yeah. Hey, y'all, a lot of times, that's the devil talking to you. That's the devil in your spirit. He'll try to discourage you, right? He'll make you feel like, watch this, that you're not good enough. Hey, y'all ever feel like that? Be for real, keep 100. I'll keep 100. I felt like that before. There are days when I have felt like I'm not good enough, right? You get ready to go on a basketball scholarship. I'm telling you that, honey, there are some days when you're going to feel like I'm so ready for this. And then there are going to be days when the devil going to try you. Yeah. Devil going to try you. He's going to get in your head. He's going to say, there are other girls here that are better than you. He's going to get in your head, and he's going to try to make you feel bad if perhaps you're not in the starting lineup. He'll get in your head and tell you that y'all going to have a losing season. And your response, when you recognize the voice of the enemy, will be what? That's cap. You talked earlier about being in barber school. There's going to come a point when you're going to take a big test. It's called the state board test. Can I get some witnesses from the grown folks? You're going to go to state board. You're going to be in a study. You're going to be in a practice on your brother's head. Everybody in the family going to let you practice cutting their head. And when it's time to go take that test, even though you studied, even though you read, and even though you practiced on some people's head, the devil's going to tell you, Devin, you can't do this. There are no other barbers in your family. Dude, you're crazy to think that you're going to actually have a barbershop one day. And when he does, you're going to respond with, that's cap. But you got to say it like you mean it. You're going to say,
that's cap.
Cap. Yeah. And then there are going to be days. Y'all know how, like, at the beginning of the school year, the teacher will have y'all do them little activities. It's like, what's your name? What's your favorite color? What do you want to be when you grow up? Right? At the beginning of school, they make you do that little paper all the time, every class. Seventh class, they all want to ask you favorite color, what you want to be when you grow up. Right? There are going to be days when what you wrote on the paper saying that you want to be when you grow up, there are going to be days when you feel like, maybe I'm not smart enough to do that. I just failed the test. I don't know anybody else that's doing that. Man, I don't think I'm the right color to be that. I don't think I'm from the right family to do that. I don't think I'm smart enough to do that. And when you hear that, I'm telling you now, that is the voice of the devil. That is the voice of Satan. And when you hear that, your response will be, y'all gotta say it like y'all mean it, because the devil ain't about to play with you. Because if the devil can steal your destiny and keep you trapped, and the devil can make you sad and make you be a nobody, he'll do it. So when you deal with the devil, you can't be no punk about it. Can't be none soft about it. You gotta be about that life with the devil. So if your response to the devil is, that's cap, Mr. Devil. He's gonna chew you up and straight you back out, and 10 years later, you're going to still be in the same spot, or maybe in a worse place, sad and depressed. So you got to have the nerve to say, devil, I ain't scared. I'm about that life. And when the enemy, when the voice of the devil comes in your mind to try to convince you that you're not going to be great, your response will be, yeah. That's what your response will be. Because he ain't got no control unless you give it to him. And how many of you, and you ain't trying to be cute, you ain't trying to be cool, you are bold enough to lift your hands and say, I will not give the devil control of my life. Where your hands at? I will not give the devil control of my life. He's not taking my destiny. I'm going to get everything that God has for me. And when I hear the voice of the devil, I don't care who mouth is coming through, because let me tell you something, baby. Sometimes the devil speaks through family.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you really think the devil wore a red costume with a stick like in movies? Yeah. The devil doesn't do that because he knows that you'll recognize it easy then. So what he does is he gets inside of people and inside of things, and he disguises himself thinking that you can't recognize him. So he'll do that by getting inside of friends, and sometimes inside of family, and sometimes he'll get inside of drugs, and sometimes he'll get inside of alcohol, and sometimes he'll slide in DMs. Yeah, sometimes the devil will text you through somebody. You got to be smart enough to recognize, this is not God talking to me. This is the devil. And when you hear the devil's voice, your response will be, that's exactly what you're going to tell. All right, so preachers, I give you this disclaimer. I'm not here to exegete a biblical text tonight. I'm here with these. How many of y'all know what this is? How many of y'all like them? Make some noise if you like ramen. Some of y'all front. Make some noise. Y'all got some of these at the house right now. Come on, make some noise. Yeah. Hey, I'm going to say the flavor. If you like it, just make some noise. Chicken. Beef. Shrimp. Pork. The new lime flavor, the lime green bag. All right. I'm with you on that. But let's hear it again for that chicken. Wonderful. Now I need you to participate. I'm here, let me be very clear. I'm here to help you recognize the voice of Satan, the devil. And I'm here to tell you some of them lies he liked to tell all of us. And I'm going to tell you these lies. I'm going to give you the key, the answer key. Y'all ever got an answer key to the test? Yeah, I'm about to give y'all the answers. So the next time you hear it, you'll go, you know what, that loud, crazy lady, Mr. Q, told us about that. All right. Y'all know what these are. Yeah. Somebody raise your hand and tell me what go with these. All right. Water. Water, yep. What else? Ice. Ice. Ice in the noodles. All right, one by one, young lady. Hot sauce, Louisiana. Mm-hmm. What else? Yeah, right there. What go in noodles? Apple cheese. But I don't care what y'all say, I put cheese in mine. Yes, ma'am. Put some chip Fritos. Yes, ma'am. What else going here? Hot Cheetos. What else going in these noodles? Y'all stop front like y'all got no noodles at the house.
Winning.
Put some eggs in there. See, they get fancy with it. Now they got Asian ones, they got Cajun ones. What else going in these noodles? With some wieners,
some
shrimp, they get real fancy with it. Shrimp, some slap your mama season, some Tony Satcher, that green, y'all know the green Tonys. What about ground beef? Ground beef go in them. What about vegetables? They put vegetables up in them. Parsley. Y'all ever try to get fancy when you get done making and shake a little bit of that green stuff in your mama cabinet, that parsley on? We put all this stuff, all right, tap in, follow me real quick. We put all this stuff in ramen noodles. But when the Maruchan company brought them to the United States of America in the 1970s, the creator of these noodles, only put, somebody find me a bowl. Someone act as my bowl. Up the offering tray. If we use the offering tray, we'll certainly keep it clean. All right, let's use that. I feel a little bit better about that. I ain't want no season to be on the fives on Sunday morning. All right, when the creator of these noodles made it, all he put in the bag was the noodles and the seasoning. All right, Foley, I want you to stand up and hold my noodles. I want you to open my pack. Hold the seasoning on top. There you go. All right, turn around, let everybody see. We got our noodles. We got our seasoning. And the reason, don't waste it, big guy. Got? Go ahead. Put on. Got? Wonderful. Thank you. Stand right there, Foley. You can see. You see the tough guy? You can be seated. You can all sit down. All right, we got our noodles. When the creator of the noodles made the noodles, all he put in the bag was the noodles and the seasoning. All right, my cousin in the back, Miss Tula, tell the truth. When we was growing up, wasn't that just fine? We didn't add nothing to it. Didn't have to add no meat. Didn't have to add no cheese. Didn't have to add no Fritos. Because what the creator put in the bag was enough. Uh-huh. Let me tell you something.
Okay.
One of the lies that the devil will tell you is that you're not enough.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He'll tell you that you're not enough to go to the NBA. He'll tell you that you're not enough to go to college on an academic scholarship. He'll tell you that you're not good enough to maintain a sports scholarship. The devil will tell you you're not good enough to grow up and be a cop. The devil will tell you that you're not good enough to grow up and be the governor of Texas. He'll tell you all the reasons that you're not enough. And if you're not careful, he will convince you that just like y'all do with the noodles, that the only way it's gonna be good is if you go add some stuff to what your creator already gave you. Now, just so we all on the same page, how many of y'all know who created you? Who created you?
God.
Say it again like you mean it. Who created you?
God.
Say it again like you mean it. Who created you?
God.
And don't you know that when God created you, God said, that's good.
Come on.
He said that was good. And when God made you, he said you was good, and he ain't asked nobody else what they felt about it. Because it didn't matter to God what nobody else thought about you. He thought you was good from the moment he made you. So God put everything in your package when he made you that you need to be good. You ain't got to put nothing on top of you. We don't have to put anything underneath you. We don't have to take anything away from you. You ain't got to go have no surgery. You don't have to change your hair.
Come on.
You don't have to make a fake accent to sound like nobody else. You don't have to change anything about you, because God put everything that you needed in your package when he made you, and your mama and daddy brought you into this world. You already had everything that you needed. And so the next time that you look in the mirror and you look at your nose, you say, man, I don't like my nose. I wish I had a nose like so-and-so. And you look at your teeth and you say, man, I don't like my teeth. I wish I had teeth like so-and-so. And you look at your lips and you say, man, I don't like my lips. I wish I had lips like so-and-so. And you look at your hair and you say, I don't like my hair. I want to cover it up. The next time you hear the enemy, the devil, speak that in your ears, your response will be, see, y'all got a little weak on me. Your response will be,
yes, God.
Because when God made me, he put everything I needed in my package, and he said, that's good. And that's what God thinks about you, that you are enough. And so I rebuke the enemy that has spoken into your ear, into your spirit, and into your heart that you're not enough. I rebuke that enemy. I'm going to tell you, this is so wonderful. You know it's so good, holding these noodles. Stay up here. You know it's so good. I wish when I was a teacher I put some noodles in my hand, because you're doing so good. You're so good. Can I tell you that because the creator of these noodles put everything in the package that they need to be good, and you might be looking at them like I'm looking at them, they're still not done. Right? Y'all know how to make noodles. That's the one thing your mama trusts you making when she ain't there. So look at these noodles, y'all. They ain't ready yet, are they? They're not ready.
No.
What do these noodles need?
Water.
The only thing
hot
they
water.
Need is some
hot water.
Can't hear y'all in here. I said the only thing they need is some
water.
They need some water. The Bible refers to the Word of God and Jesus, watch this, as living water. What I'm saying is when you realize that you are enough, the only extra thing you need is Jesus and the Word of God. When you pour that water on these noodles, now you got something getting ready to pop off.
Yeah.
Okay. When you pour the Word of God, how many of y'all got a Bible? Wonderful. How many of you have a cell phone? Right. So if you don't have a paper Bible and you got a cell phone on the cool, you still got a Bible. Because you can go to Google and you can type in Bible and you low-key still got it. You still got a Bible. You can download the Bible app. Right. So when you take the Word of God, because honey, when you go to college, you better take it with you. You need the Word of God. When you go to college, more than you need a backpack, more than you need a MacBook, more than you need your cell phone, more than you need your teammates, more than you need your jersey. When you go to college, you need the Word of God. You need the living water. Why? Because the Word of God cleanses.
Yeah.
Right? It cleanses, means those parts of us that's dirty. It removes those things from us. And water also revitalizes us. It gives us strength. It gives us energy. That's why we need the Word of God in our lives. So watch this. The next lie the enemy gonna try to tell y'all. Alright, so I'm gonna go on, get your heads up. The next lie the devil getting ready to start telling y'all, if he hadn't already tried, is that the Word of God is not true. The next lie the devil is getting ready to try to tell you is that God is optional. Same way, I don't want no noodles without water. You ought not want your life without the Word of God in your life. So next thing that the devil's about to start doing, he'll try to convince you by way of certain stuff you read on Facebook, certain things you might hear at your school, and certain things that might pop up on your TikTok. He'll try to convince you that God is optional. Okay? And so what'll happen when you start waking up and your mama saying, let's go to church, inside he'll start to tell you, that's a stupid place. Why do you go there?
Yeah.
And then when you have free time and you're on your TikTok and your Snap and your Instagram and you could be reading the Bible, he'll say things like to you, like, why would you want to read a boring book like that? And your response, when you hear the voice of the devil, will be what? Because you understand that if I ain't got nothing else, if I ain't got no shrimp on me, if I ain't got no ground beef on me, if I don't have any cheese on me, if I don't have any Fritos on me, I need the water. If I don't have no friends, I need God. If I ain't got no boyfriend, I need God. Come on, talk to me. If I don't have a girlfriend, I need God. If I ain't got no weed, I need God.
Yeah.
Amen.
If I can't make the next party, I need God. If I can't turn up, I need God. That's the one thing. Take my advice. You cannot afford to live or die.
That's it.
Don't think for a second that you're going to be that one person who can live without God. Honey, you need him. Take my word. Take my word. I'm looking in your eyes because I'm serious. Can't tell them I'm serious. That's the one thing that you can't live without. So this is missing water. All right? So pretend we're making these noodles. Okay, Bob, we're making these noodles up here. They're looking good. We have added our water to these noodles. Would they be finished?
No.
No, man. No, because they ain't finished. What's the next thing we got to do? Somebody say, put them in the microwave.
Put them in the microwave
for how long? Some people say 4 minutes.
Some say 3.
Some people say 6 minutes. Y'all like a mushy. Those 6 minute people. Some people say 5. She say 3. See, I like them firm like you. 4 minutes and 30 seconds right there in between. We've got to add water. Once we add water, we are all on the same page. Then we got to have something that's going to give us some heat. He was another lie the devil liked to tell us. He likes to tell you that problems are punishment. Tell the truth. Y'all are young, but tell the truth. Raise your hand if you already got problems. Man, people be thinking because y'all are young that y'all don't ever get afraid and that you don't ever get discouraged and that nothing ever makes you angry and that you ain't never confused inside and that people don't ever bother you and that folks ain't never mean to you and that you don't ever long for relationships with certain people in your life. People be thinking because you're young that you don't have problems. And one of the things that the devil loves to do is convince you that the problems that you face and the stuff that's bad in your life is your fault. And that it's punishment because you've done something wrong. Well, let me tell you this. My grandma used to say this, and it's true. My grandma used to say, if you make your bed hard, you got to lay it. What that meant was, if you mess up, you got to deal with the consequences.
Right.
And grandma was right.
Yeah.
But there are times when you have problems and stuff will be popping off in your life and stuff will be going wrong and you didn't do nothing wrong. The devil's not going to tell you that. Can I tell you this? That God will send heat, hot times, hard times, depressing times into your life. Watch this. It's not to punish you. It's to develop you. Because God understands that if you can stick with him through tough stuff, and if you can stay with him through tough stuff, it'll make you stronger, and it'll give you a stronger relationship with him. And some kind of way, I need some grown folks to help me right here. Some kind of way, when we go through difficult stuff, when we come out on the other side, we be stronger, don't we?
Yeah.
I wish I had some help in this church. We be wiser, don't we?
Yeah.
Are there any people who can say, after going through tough stuff in my life, baby, it might have hurt like hell, but when I came out of it, I was better when I came out than I was when... How many of y'all can just stop and give God praise? Because I went through some stuff, but I came out of it better. Might have had to cry, but I came out of it better. I might have struggled. I might have had to press my way, but I came out of it better because God let the problems in my life do to me what he does to ramen noodles, and they developed me to a state of maturity. They made me who I needed to be. Let me tell you this. The devil not going to tell you this, but the hard stuff that y'all had to go through as young people, it's not for a waste. God has a way of bringing beautiful stuff out of ugly situations.
He
has a way of doing that. And so when the devil tries to convince you, it needed to happen to you. Because you bad. Because you dumb. Because you ignorant. Because you stupid. Because you trifling. Because you ratchet. Let me tell you something. Your response ought to be this. Watch what my God does with it. Watch what my God does with the moments when I don't feel like I'm enough. Watch what my God does with the moments that make me cry. And so we put our water, we put our heat with these noodles. We stir them up. Tell the truth. Don't y'all stir them up. Because you like to see them noodles turn the color of the seasoning. Can I get a witness in the room? And there are moments. Have you ever been in a place in life where it felt like your life was just doing this? You was trying to get control of yourself, but you was just spinning, and things were just spinning out of control. Raise your hand if you ever been there. And it seemed like when something finally get right, before you know it, something bad happened again. That's just God sticking his fork in you, stirring up the gifts that are inside of you, stirring up the great things that are inside of you. Sometimes God just gets you shaking. Because he's pulling something out of you that wouldn't have came out if he didn't shake stuff up in your life. God does that. And once you stir it up, it's ready to eat. It's ready to eat. Give Jaden a hand. I appreciate it. Raise your hand if you'll never look at some noodles the same. How many plan to eat some in the next day or so? Now, I'm telling you this, and I'm almost out of your hair. I'll tell you this. Y'all got UIL at school. UIL. So when I was in the second grade, because I'm telling you one more thing, the devil will try to use against you. He'll try to like beat you down when you make a mistake. Tell the truth, have you ever failed a quiz or a test before? You felt really bad afterwards, right? Raise your hand if you ever got a referral at school. Now keep your hand raised if you kind of felt bad after you did. Yeah. All right, how many of y'all ever got in trouble at home, got a whooping? Tell the truth. You kind of felt bad afterwards. One of the things the devil will do, the devil will try to convince you that your mistake is the end. He'll try to convince you that the mistake you made is the end of the world. And all you will think about is the fact that you messed up and that you're embarrassed and that you might even feel humiliated. Or you might be embarrassed that you made that mistake publicly. And when you hear the voice of the enemy, when you hear the voice of the devil trying to convince you that your mistake was the end, your response will be, I need some people on this side, because if not, the devil gonna try you on the very thing that I'm talking about. When the enemy tries to convince you that your mistake is the end, your response will be, because everybody done messed up before. Mama them done messed up. Your pastor them done messed up. I've messed up. Everybody's messed up before. Here's the kicker. When you mess up, you can't stop right there. Are you with me? So when I was in the second grade, I had tried out for UIL storytelling. Right? We got some storytelling people in the room. How many of y'all ever did UIL before? Right? You know about it. You stay after school and you practice. I did storytelling for UIL. I was horrible. Y'all, I never forget it. I was 8 years old. We went to the UIL meet in Walla. Man, I ain't even place. I was ashamed. I couldn't even hold my tears in. Have you ever been embarrassed and you didn't want to cry in front of your friends, but before you knew it, you was crying? It was just too late. The tears were out. Come on. You ever cried at school? Yeah. Before I knew it, I was crying in front of everybody. Now, check this out. If I would have stopped, man, from Ohio, if I would have stopped telling stories when I was 8 years old because I failed and I didn't even get a place, let me show y'all something. I wrote two books. Yeah. I wrote two books. All right? That was an awesome guess. Yeah, I wrote two books. But what would have happened if when I was 8 and the devil got in my mind and said, you're stupid, you shouldn't even came in here and try to tell no stories. You don't know about no storytelling. Those two books wouldn't exist.
Right.
When you look at them, I want them to prove to you that it's okay to make a mistake.
Yes.
You just got to build on the mistakes that you made.
Right. Right.
And so when the enemy tries to tell you that you're dumb, that you're stupid, that you can't become anything, that you can't produce anything, your response will be, because it is. All right. This last thing I'm getting ready to do, if it's okay, we'll turn cameras. We'll say goodbye to our online audience.
Say bye-bye.
Because I have one more line of business. And let me first say this. I really appreciate how good of an audience y'all have been.